there are so many exciting things here at the photography show, and I'm just like an excited teenager. I'm at the Droneflights stand, and just here we've got some of the most exciting types of cameras that I've seen here today. I'm joined by Andrew. Hey, how are you doing?
Hi. Yeah, very well, thank you. Yeah.
So, Droneflight. I wonder what they do. Tell us a bit about what's on the table here.
Well, what we've got on this table, we've got a very low cost, low entry point drone, which is called a Phantom 2. Yep. But it has actually got quite a sophisticated gimbal system underneath.
So tell me what a gimbal is.
What a gimbal is if I hold this up to the camera, touch, you keep this. This will keep the camera steady when it's moving, so you get smoother footage. And it works really, really well. And actually, these are incredibly cheap. I mean, this is sort of £650 to get in the air. You just have to add your GoPro.
So this is specifically for the GoPro.
Yep.
What sort of range do you get from one of these?
Well, there's two answers to that. One is there's what it's capable of, and then the other answer is what you're legally allowed to do. Okay. What it's capable of is you'd get a range of about 1.5 kilometers quite easily. But what you're legally allowed to do in the UK is basically up to 500 meters away and 400 feet in the air.
Right, and is that to do with like civil aviation authority stuff?
Yeah, visual line of sight. You need what's termed visual line of sight. And in practice, if you look at the Phantom, it's white. And in reality, in bad conditions, the Phantom, you actually really need to fly it a bit closer to you than that.
Right, okay. Yeah. Now, I'm interested in the potential uses for this, because in the UK, certainly, we've seen an awful lot of floods over the last few weeks. And amount of the news coverage that I've seen that's been provided by, I presume, either very low-flying, quiet helicopters or by drones is astonishing. So is it mainly for journalistic purposes, or are there other uses as well?
There are a lot of really interesting uses. I mean, we have a client who looks at installs antennas, really large antennas, and they need to look at the top of those antennas to actually check that everything's in order. And it's a very expensive job to actually take the kit there. And if you get a drone, it's actually very cheap and it can be done very much quicker. The other thing is farming. People use them in farming to identify the health of the plants and actually put that information into their crop sprays, so that they actually just spray the pesticide or herbicide in the right place.
Terrific.
So there's some interesting uses other than just photography.
Now, you've got a number of different drones here at the show. So let's just take a look at this one here. This is the next step up, I guess. What's this one called?
This is called a Quad 4. This is basically from Steady Drone in South Africa. It's all made of carbon fiber. It's a quite a high performance machine for its size. And I mean, if you get hold of it, it's quite light. Go for it. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. But one of its other features is this business of
Don't
you can actually
it.
Look at that. You can actually fold this up. The arms are all foldable, and then you can actually fold the legs in, and you can actually get that in a rucksack.
Wow.
And that's awesome.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's incredible. And with all of these, you control them using the kind of dedicated remote control system here as
that's
well.
That's correct.
It looks a bit like a bumblebee, like that, as
yes,
you know.
It is, yes. I mean, it's a shame we can't really fly them in here, but I mean, they are tremendous to see flying.
Sure.
And they're very, very agile.
Now, this little dongle on the front here, this is a GPS unit, isn't it?
Yeah. So basically, what it's doing is it's getting its location information from the GPS satellites, and it's trying to remain stable in space. So if we had one flying now, I could quite literally give you the remote control, and you just not touch anything, and it would just stay where we left it. And then if you want to, you know, I tell you what to do with it, and you'd be able to move it around, and you'd feel quite comfortable with it, probably within 10-15 minutes. You'd think, actually, this is good fun.
Let's take a look at some of these larger drones over here. These are really impressive. What's this one called?
This is called the Quad 4X. This is quite a beast, actually. This will lift 8 kilograms, and it will actually fly for 60 minutes. 60 minutes. It's quite a serious platform. Again, it's all carbon fiber. I said to you earlier on, you should try lifting this, but just get hold of it and just lift it up a bit and see what you think.
I'll tell you what.
Go for it.
Hold that for me.
Yeah.
Here we go. Wow.
That's amazing, isn't it?
That's
unbelievably light, isn't it?
Very, very exciting. And this isn't... It's very impressive, but you've got another one that follows a slightly different model over here.
Okay, one trick to show you.
Oh, no, please. Is this going to fold up as well?
This one folds up as well. So look at that. all those arms fold in, and basically you can put that in a very small flight case, so it's really transportable, immensely useful for, you know, somebody who's traveling around going to assignments.
And like you say, if some of the uses of these are in remote areas and stuff, then having them portable like this makes perfect sense.
It does. Well, this is never really that portable. The little one is more portable, but this is pretty portable for something of this scale and this capability.
What sort of weight can you lift with one of these?
8 kilograms.
Wow.
Yeah.
So it's not just a camera that you can carry on here, it's potentially other stuff as well.
Yeah. I mean, people put all sorts of things on these. For example, at Sellafield, they actually have a drone that's flying around that has a radiological sensor on it, so that they're trying to sample the air, you know, so it's not just cameras. And people do put very big cameras under drones. They put, you know, things all the way up to a Red Epic underneath here. In fact, you know, we can put a Red Epic compatible gimbal underneath this, and you can fly your expensive camera around if you wish.
It is just cheaper than hiring a helicopter for the afternoon, isn't it?
It is an awful lot cheaper than flying a helicopter.
Do you know, I don't know if you've got a view on this, but there's been a lot of stuff in the news lately about companies like Amazon who've been experimenting with using drones. I mean, what's the use case for Amazon to buy drones then?
Well, interestingly enough, I think their practicalities in a built-up area like the UK's is a bit